This is Nick, and you're watching the Freezer Show. And that's 9 degrees. Thank you, guys. You sound great. How's everybody doing? We've got a great show for you tonight. We have radio personality Torgo on the show. Let's hear it for Torgo. We'll find out who he is in a minute. And somebody I've been wanting to get on the show since day one, Jimmy Dean from Sarasota Magazine, is here tonight. Yeah. Hi, how are you doing, Nick? Ugh. Did you have a good Thanksgiving?
Yeah, I'm stuffed, man.
Yeah, it looks like it. Yeah. You guys have fun? What'd you do?
Yeah, had a good time. Well, ever since my second wife left me 5 years ago.
Sad but true.
Stan and I have a little thing. It's kind of like a tradition. Every Thanksgiving we get together and, you know, stuff ourselves. Yeah. Yeah.
Nice.
But let's, you know, that's a whole different thing. What'd you do?
Well, one word. Tofurkey.
Tofurkey who?
Yeah, exactly. Well, it's kind of payback. My wife and I used to be vegetarian. About 8 years, we actually vegan. Somebody's applauding that. So this year, as it turns out, we had my wife's cousin over, vegan, and her husband, and our neighbors over, strict vegetarians. So,
are those Star Trek people? What do you mean?
Vegans? No. That's Vulcans. Vegans don't eat anything with a face. No, nothing that has a mom. They won't eat meat or anything. So,
I don't get the hippies at all, but
yeah. So it's kind of retribution for us. So I've got all these leftovers. I got tofurkey and vegan gravy and
Stan and I have some leftovers too.
You and oh yeah. You why do you and Stan have leftovers? I thought you were stuffed. You ate everything, didn't you?
Well. Yeah, but I miss my kids, so we always cook for eight, and kind of.
Nice. Well, we've got plenty of leftovers here. We'll have to dig in. I'm not sure what we're gonna do with
it. Yeah, what? Only if we had a chef.
Guys.
Oh.
I'm a chef.
Chef Mario, everybody. Come on up.
How's it going?
Can you do anything for us here?
I think I can do something here. I brought some tools here.
Now, we didn't rehearse this, but do you guys have any, like, cooking music?
Yeah, I need a little cooking music. Here we go, because I'm getting ready to go to work. Okay, let's put some gloves on over here.
Chef Mario, everybody.
Thank you. Sure, my pleasure.
We'll be right back after this break.
All right, yeah.
Everybody come on up and have some meats. Welcome back to the show. Now I'm even more full after eating that sandwich.
Yeah.
Washing it down with some Budweiser.
You didn't
you guys
leave.
Enjoying the Budweiser out there? Yeah. Now don't forget, Monday nights after the show, come on over to Chrome. Where's Chrome? 301 and 12th?
It's like between, I think, like 7th and 10th Street or something.
It's
on 301.
Right next to the Harley Davidson.
Fantastic.
That's right.
Okay, so come on down. They're it's open up to just the, for the freezer.
It's open to the public after 9 o'clock.
Oh, okay.
So starting at 9, it's open to the public, so anyone can come out.
Come on down to Chrome. Let's bring out our first guest. Our first guest is radio personality Torgo. He's from Free Talk Live. Let's find out what Torgo's all about. Let's give him a big warm welcome. Welcome. Wow, that sounded ominous.
Yeah.
Welcome,
that's okay.
Torgo. So, Torgo.
Yep.
Is that your birth name? Is that your given name?
Middle name.
That's your wrestling
middle
name.
Middle name. Your wrestling
name.
Actually, if I was going to wrestle, I would use that. It's the best chanting name in the world.
Sure.
Yeah, no, you've got an audience here. Come on, do it.
Torgo.
Torgo. They already know the rhythm. It's the best chanting name ever.
What does it mean? What's Torgo?
It's actually, it's from the worst movie ever made, Manos, The Hands of Fate. See, people have seen it. It's a... Torgo, I guess they had a budget of like $8 on this movie.
Yeah.
Torgo was
twice our budget.
Torgo was a monster. His monstrous feature, really big knees.
Really?
Yeah, he had really big knees.
And
that music is what played every time you walked into a room.
Like that. So that's your radio name.
Yeah.
And you have a real name, but we don't want to talk about
Let's
that
here. Let's not talk
about
that here.
That's your radio name? You want to go by that?
My real name, I share it with a celebrity, and I really don't want to bring his reputation down, so.
Okay. So we'll go by Torgo.
Yeah.
So tell us about your radio show. What's that all about, and when is it on?
It's called Free Talk Live. It airs Monday through Saturday nights from 8 to 10 on with some of our unofficial affiliates, about 20-some-odd radio stations across the country.
Oh, nationwide.
Yep. None of them local. Not a single one. We have no local affiliates.
We can't hear you here in Sarasota?
No, we've alienated every local station. So.
Is that right?
Yeah, we've been on three so far. We're not on a one.
Well, you're one of those damn crazy liberals, aren't you?
Libertarian. There's a difference.
Oh, is that? Oh, okay.
So what's the show about? Is it politics?
Politics, pop culture, anything anybody wants to call in about, they can always call in at any time.
Is it a call-in show?
Yep. Yeah, we have a tendency to talk about politics, liberty-oriented issues, freedom-oriented issues. I also like to talk about porn. So it's politics and porn.
Yeah!
Well, that goes hand in hand, doesn't it?
You seem to attract these people at this show, don't you?
But I mean, we've gone so far as we were talking about Social Security one night, had some guy call in, want to talk about sandwiches. So we switched the topic up right on the spot from Social Security to sandwiches.
So are you more Imus or more Franken?
Oh, God, do I have to be either one?
No, maybe not. I don't know. I just...
No, you know, it's...
Middle of the road?
Middle of the road, I guess you could say that, because... We take what's, the Libertarian Party takes kind of what's the best of both sides and put them together into one party that makes sense. So that's kind of the viewpoint we put together on the show.
So why are you not on in Sarasota? Did you really alienate some
companies? I don't know if we alienated anyone. We actually started out locally on 105.9 FM back when they were talk. And then we moved to a couple of AM stations and got picked up on satellite. No one else locally has picked us up.
So. What about the internet? Can we hear you on the internet?
Yep, we can be heard live every night, Monday through Saturday, from 8 to 10 Eastern on freetalklive.com. We also have a podcast available for people who are podcast listeners. We're actually consistently rated in the top 5 podcasts in the world on podcastalley.com.
I feel stupid. What's a podcast?
That's
iPod is?
Do you have an iPod? Okay.
No. What is an iPod?
People can subscribe to our show, and their computer will download the new episodes for them every day.
And you can listen to it on your little portable.
You can listen to it on a portable, you can listen to it on your computer, but you don't have to be there live. Your computer will send you the show automatically every day if you want it.
They do that with Desperate Housewives, right?
Yeah, sort of. Kind of.
Am I telling too much about myself?
Yes.
We're a little less catty.
Okay, well. Yeah.
So you're on every night? Why are you here tonight?
There are 5 hosts. I'm only on Fridays. The main two, Ian and Manwich, are there every night of the week.
Manwich,
yeah.
Another sandwich reference.
So Ian,
it's not a sandwich, it's a meal.
That's right. And he is, in fact, thick and hearty, much like myself. So,
is he?
Well, at least he's not like Wendy, hot and juicy. And that was the owner's daughter. So
what nights are you on?
Friday.
Bring this back around here.
Friday nights.
Friday nights. Okay.
Yeah.
5 different hosts.
5 different. Like I said, Ian and Manwich are there every night, and then we have 3 others that do one night a week each. Johnson on Mondays, Jason on Wednesdays, and then myself on Fridays.
Okay. And do you have guests come on?
Sometimes we've had the Libertarian Party presidential candidate on the show, but then also like.
Sounds exciting.
We're going to have stand-up comics on the show. We'll have Doug Stanhope on the show in a couple of weeks. So just really whatever range of anybody we feel like having.
And you do stand-up, right? I hear?
I do from time to time. I haven't made a dollar yet, but that's okay. I'm working on it.
Are you making an appearance anytime soon?
Yeah, if anybody wants to come see how funny I'm not, December 11th at McCurdy's Comedy Theater for Open Mic Night. That's right.
That's great. We're going to have to work on your pitch, though. That's not really going to bring people in.
Trust me, you can go to the website, and there's a link to a video of my first time ever doing stand-up.
Was it better than Nick? Nick did stand-up on the show.
I did do stand-up on the show.
I saw that a couple of weeks ago.
And what do you think?
You don't have to answer that.
Funny.
It was. I laughed. See? I'll tell you, I laughed.
Painfully funny. So do you go by Torgo when you're on stage doing stand-up?
I do, yeah.
Okay.
I used to use a last name, but it didn't fit. It was Torgo Martel for a period of time, which is also not my real last name. Just, I don't know where it came from. I dropped it because it sucked.
Okay. Well,
I have no end to that story. I'm sorry.
I almost just called you by your real name. Torgo, thanks for coming.
Thank you.
We're going to take a break, and we'll be back. Hey, stick around. We're going to do trivia challenge with Jimmy later, okay? So we'll be right back after this. Thank you.
Stand on the street for the freezer, and we're here at the Sarasota Mall on the biggest shopping day of the year. White meat or dark meat?
White.
Dark meat, definitely dark meat.
Dark meat. White.
If I was a pie, what kind would I be?
Pumpkin.
A fruit pie.
Sweetie pie.
Pumpkin.
Blueberry.
Minced meat.
Chocolate. Naughty or nice?
Nice. Nice.
Very naughty.
Both.
Naughty?
Naughty.
You have to be both.
I'm naughty.
Nice.
Naughty.
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 That's why I'm not getting anything. Real or fake?
No.
Real or fake?
Real?
Real.
Real.
Fake. Go for real.
For real.
They're real.
The tree.
Oh, real.
Christmas Eve or Christmas morning?
Christmas morning. Ah, oh, Christmas Eve.
Christmas Eve.
Eve.
Christmas morning.
Christmas morning.
New Year's Eve.
Easter questions.
Welcome to People's Community Bank. How may I help you today?
We're from the freezer. I'm Craig, this is Nick, and we need to cash this check.
No problem. I'll just need to see some...
Oh, ID. Nick?
How about this?
You know, freezer show.
Craig, Nick, we know you guys. We all watch your show here.
At People's Community Bank, we take security very seriously. But we also take pride in treating our customers like people and not numbers.
So we'd be happy to cash your check today.
Sweet. Skin, what are you playing over there? Is that a flute or a piccolo?
It's a skin flute.
A skin flute. I stepped right into that one, didn't I? Yeah. Welcome back to the show. Everybody enjoying Rico's Pizza?
Yeah!
All right. Thank you, Rico's. Thank you, Rico's.
And you can wash it down with an ice cold Budweiser.
All right, let's bring out our next guest. He is the publisher, owner, editor, writer. I don't know, we'll find out. He runs Sarasota Magazine. Let's give a big warm welcome to Jimmy Dean. Welcome, Jimmy.
It's great to be here, Craig.
How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
So, good. So you tell us a little bit about yourself. You run Sarasota Magazine, is that right?
Well, I heard in the green room that you said I owned it, and I really don't own it anymore.
And you don't really write for it or
really,
edit it,
I don't do
you?
Anything no, there I made anymore. All that up. I just show up and, you know.
You make all the magic happen.
Right. I just, you know, kind of hang around.
Now, did you start Sarasota Magazine?
No, actually, my former partner started it, and I joined him a couple of years into it, and that was about 25 years ago, and it seems like 10 minutes. But
really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's you know fast. What? I forgot. We got to do a nice plug here.
Oh, here's yeah.
December issue. When just does out. This hit the...
This will hit the newsstands.
Yeah. Isn't that pretty?
Jimmy did the painting.
No, I didn't.
Oh.
I really have very little to do with the magazine other than keep the folks happy.
Sure.
That's my job.
And how do you keep them happy?
Pay them.
See, that's our problem here. That's why everyone's so disgruntled. I will talk. We'll talk later.
Yeah, we'll.
That is a problem.
It's kind of a prerequisite.
This was actually the best issue of the year.
Thank you. Because it has your story
we're
in it?
Yes, we're
right.
In it.
Right, well, funny how that happens. Thank you.
Show!
It's funny how you're on the show now.
Isn't that weird?
Interesting.
Really.
So tell me about...
Can I start off by saying you guys are doing a good job?
Yeah. Oh, thank you. Yeah. Thank you. Yeah. I appreciate that.
This is honestly only about the second time, and I love Don Gersio, the guy that really runs Blab, but I have been asked to be on Blab probably several hundred times.
Really?
But I've always been busy.
Ah.
And well, you are a busy man.
I'm a pretty busy guy. I have 4 kids under 7. You don't know
Whoa.
Busy.
Whoa.
So
busy. I've got 8 kids, so.
You have 8 children?
If you heard it, yeah, that's why.
He's a wise ass, isn't he?
Yes. Oh, you haven't seen the show before, have you?
I've seen the show, and he's a wise ass.
He is a wise ass.
But anyway, I said I would come on the show as long as you did not embarrass me with sausage jokes.
Oh, no.
What do you mean?
I don't know what that means.
Jimmy Dean sausage. My name is Jimmy Dean.
Oh.
I thought you were the Rebel Without a Cause guy. I had a big joke for that. What do you mean? Now I got to I need new note cards. Go, you guys go ahead. I got to figure
out.
We wouldn't
ass.
Do the Jimmy Dean. We wouldn't.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
So tell me about you, though. You grew up here in Sarasota?
I've never grown up.
That's what I've heard. Yeah.
No, I was born in Burlington, North Carolina, on the right side of the road.
What does that mean?
So are you Tar Heel or Wolfpack or Tar Heel or Duke?
I'm a Dookie. I'm a Dookie. I'm dark blue. My blood's dark blue.
Oh, okay.
And moved here about 25 years ago and nailed my feet to the ground and haven't been out of town since.
It's a great place to live.
It's a great place to raise children.
And then you also, do you sing or you're narrating a show that's coming up, right?
I do a lot of public speaking.
Oh, you do? Okay.
Because until you guys came along, not many people could talk. In town. So I get asked to do a lot of public speaking, and consequently I get myself into things I don't really know how to get out of. But this one thing coming up next month I'm very excited about. The Florida West Coast Symphony is doing Peter and the Wolf.
Oh,
and they
okay.
have asked me to be the narrator. And I've always dreamed of performing with a 100-piece orchestra.
Wow.
And I get to do that, and my little old North Carolina voice gets to be my instrument.
Oh, that'd be great.
It's going to be fun.
That'd be fun. That's coming up
December 18th and 19th. The 18th is going to be for all of my fans in
Nick, what are you doing?
Northport.
You are a damn good-looking man, I got to tell you. And I say that, I'm going to get married February 18th, so there's really nothing, you know, man, but you are a damn good-looking man, isn't he?
I said I was, I'm a real shy guy. And you're a real smart ass.
Well, you said that, yeah.
All right, you do like girls, right?
Oh, yeah, okay. No, yeah, absolutely. I mean that man to man, like a Viking. Like you're a damn good looking man.
Nick,
you know,
you're not bad yourself.
Guys,
thank you.
Smart ass.
Try to keep from touching each other too much.
So, anyway, where was
yeah,
I?
Yeah, so anyway,
December 18th, 19th, 18th is in Northport. And the 19th is at the Sarasota Opera House, and you're all invited. Peter and the Wolf.
Great. So I also want to talk about Sarasota Magazine was just bought. I'd like to talk about that the company that bought you and what that's all about and what you're bringing to Sarasota.
Okay.
So
want to talk about it now, or you want to take
a
break?
No, let's go have some coffee.
Okay.
You two should get together. You're both smart asses, aren't you? No, but you're owned by the Robb Report now?
We are owned by the Robb Report now. The gentleman who acquired our company a year ago is, quite frankly, one of the smartest publishers I've ever met. He runs the Robb Report. He owns Worth Magazine. He owns Showboats International. And now we have San Diego Magazine, Gulf Shore Life in Naples, and Sarasota Magazine, and it's wonderful. It's a lot of fun. It's going to do great things for the community.
Now, too. A lot of our crowd, no offense, but they can't really afford the Auto Trader, so you might want to tell them what the Rob... you might want to tell them what the Rob Report is.
Well, the Rob Report is, quite simply, it's the world's best magazine on connoisseurship. You know, cigars, jets, yachts, diamonds. Pick up a copy, okay?
I can't afford it.
And so you guys are going to do some events here in the coming year?
We're going to do two major events in Sarasota next year, one in March with Worth Magazine and one in November at the Cotizan Mansion of John and Mabel Ringling, and November with Rob Report Magazine.
Wow.
And they're going to be great parties.
Oh, I bet.
Trust me, great parties.
Nothing but the best, right?
Nothing but the best.
Great. Well, I think we've run out of time. Thank you for coming.
Well, can I say hey to my kids?
Absolutely.
Hi, Clark. Hi, Jimmy. Hi, Winona. Hi, Elise.
And you have twins, right?
I have twins. Winona and Elise are the twins. They're four. And they're identical. So, I can mix them up and they never know. Clark is five. And Jimmy Jr. is seven. And he is starring in, he did Peter Pan last year at the Oslo. He was Michael the baby. And he is rehearsing tonight. And he will be opening December 1st with the Players Theater production of Oliver. So,
and he's eight.
He'll be eight.
Okay. Tell them they should go to bed now if they're watching.
Yeah, they're not watching.
They're probably watching. Go to bed, kids. Okay.
Well, thanks, Jimmy. It's
Craig.
Been a pleasure. Thanks for coming out. We'll be right back after this break.
Good to see you.
And we'll play a trivia challenge. To the freezer. Now it's that time in the show where I pass it off to Nick for trivia challenge. This time it's between Jimmy and Torgo. Take it away, Nick.
Thank you, Craig. All right, gentlemen, Torgo. This is our trivia challenge. I'm going to ask you a series of trivia questions. First one to buzz in has a chance to answer the question. In case of a tiebreaker, I'm going to go to a closest two. Jimmy, I'll ask you first, Torgo second. There's no reason to buzz in on that one. It's not over under, it's closest two.
I think I understand.
Here we go.
Is this
first question.
Well, this one's for everybody, I think.
Okay. Who originally composed the symphony Peter and the Wolf? Jimmy.
From Poland, Sergei Prokofiev.
Mm. It is Sergei. Yes.
Now I know what all that was about. Oh, you're a damn fine-looking man. You fed him that question. Viking camaraderie, is that what that was?
He's a sponsor, Torgo. He keeps us alive, okay? So. Next question. What is the nighttime wattage of radio station WXNT in Indianapolis, Indiana?
What?
Torgo.
5,000? 5,000.
What?
Watts.
That's right, it is 5,000 watts.
I feel like a Viking.
All right. We're tied. Okay. We're going to go to a closest two. Jimmy, I'll ask you first. Torgo second. Okay. According to the Center for Disease Control, what percentage of the average American family's food budget is spent on fast food?
Do we have to buzz in?
No.
I'd say 30%.
Higher.
67%.
67%?
Yeah, random number.
40%. Jimmy Dean is our winner of Trivia Challenge.
I am so not the average.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you, Ariel.
I got a copy of my own magazine.
Again, you're a sponsor. Thank you.
Thank you, Jimmy. Great show. We'll see you next Monday at 9 o'clock. Thanks, everybody, for coming.
Thank you all.
Take all the fun.